Hello everybody, welcome back to another more mod build. In looking at this thing and taking the measurements from the engine, I thought I would have enough room, but I'm not going to. I'm going to need to cleave off more of this shelving inside here, the support. I'm gonna have to cut down through and cut out more of this steel, because after I put the engine inside, the exhaust and the air intake, the carburetor area is going to collide with that bar. So I need to move this all forward. But that steel right there is in the way of the engine. So I have to cut out another chunk of that steel. I'm probably just going to cut straight up, across, and then over here, cut across, and then take that chunk out. I'm not going to deal with these little side pieces here. All right, guys, I just got that done. Yeah, cut right through here, cut straight across, and then get the camera over here. There we go. Damn, why is this camera? It's weird. It's like it's creating a blurriness. Okay, and I left the big old chunk over there, but that hopefully doesn't collide with the engine. So. Now, I gotta figure out the plate stuff. Well, I went to pick this thing up, brush my hand across it, grab it. That bad boy jumped out at my hand. Cut me all the way down. It's only about a, I don't know, maybe a half inch cut, but it's deep, really deep, because it hit my hand, hit it, sliced in and pushed my hand away. It went really deep. Ran into the house and, yep, spread my hand open like that to wash it off. Sure enough, I could see meat bulging out from it. You know, fatty tissue and stuff. Yeah. But, cleaned it up, put a Band-Aid on it, put a wrap around it, put some Neosporin on it. Yeah. Now I'm back out here working. Keep going. Well, everybody, got that part put on there. Let me adjust the light a little bit here. Okay, now how I set this up, I eyeballed where the drain plug was going to be, and then about another inch behind there is going to be where the bolts, where I put the bolts in. So the drain plug should come really close to this bar right here. I'm going to try to move it as close as I possibly can without touching the drain plug. The oil plug to this bar, because we don't want any vibration messing up that oil plug. So I got it welded here, here, and on the outside in there, and then also on the inside. I tipped this thing back on all fours and then welded the inside plate too. So this is pretty solid. Okay, now it's time to lay this thing back down, and then I have to cut out this area, so that way the engine will be able to fit down inside of there. All right, well, I got these notches cut out right here, here, and I took the tank off of the machine, of the engine, and rotated the pull cord. Plate that I welded on is slightly forward too much. Yeah. And the support bar for the footrest here, the drain plug is right up against it. So I actually welded the plate on a little too far forward, because the bolt holes for the engine are directly over the edge of the plate. So, okay, fix that. It's a really tight fit. Yep, and I'm literally touching the wall over there on the other side. So this thing is just wide enough. I'm going to probably have to cut out some. Probably cut a little bit more of this off right here, because that's just way too close to the air filter container. The exhaust doesn't touch. I'll probably have to do something on the side here so I can actually stick. I'm going to put a torque converter on this, not just a clutch. Putting a clutch on something like this, you know, it ain't going to be very impressive. If I put a torque converter, that's a different story, because that'll, whoa, rip these tires going. And this part here sticking up out of the belly. Top there. I'm going to be able to put the bolts back in for the dashboard. Still got my steering all okay. And my bolts up. And I'll probably have to end up covering this all up with a piece of steel, so it's hidden. Give it just a rest on the bolts there. Here.
They'll never know. Oh yeah. I'm gonna have to, whatever piece of steel I put up over that, I'm gonna have to get to blend in. And then take the tank, because the tank sits right here. Connect the tank down to the engine. After I mount it. Yeah. Alright guys, so there we go. Video number 2. I'm going to get on out of here. I got to go in and change this dressing on this cut. And yeah, tell me what you guys think of that. I think that's pretty interesting. Alright, so I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.